All right, welcome to the session 2 of the lecture 11, and we are going to see the rules for the dissection into this session, and we will start by this. So as I told you into the previous session that this is a very similar thing, that if I say that I have phi, then you can say that okay, either I have phi or I have psi. This is definitely also true, na? If you have mango and you say that either I have mango or apple, you are right, okay. So you can introduce at the first place, means the right thing is at the first place, or you can say that at the second place. If you have mango, you say I have apple and mango, mango and apple, similar things, okay. The interesting part is this elimination. Now the elimination is a bit different here, because into the R things you cannot simply eliminate the things. You need to find out the two things that starting if, because phi and psi are the two things, either you have apple or you have the mango, okay. It may be possible both the things are with you, but in case only one of things with you, then you cannot remove this particular part, okay. Very easily you cannot remove this. So therefore the technique used is this, that if from the phi, if you start from the phi, there is some, this particular bracket means, this particular rectangle means that this is your area where you started with the phi, you do some computation and you come up with some x something, that something you come up with this. And from the second part also you do something and you come up with the x, okay. Then you can say that x, because from both the things are actually originating x, then you can say the x. So this is how you can eliminate, means you can eliminate the R dissection from the given equation. All right, is it clear? So now we have this formula that says that P R Q, and you have to tell that it is equivalent to the Q R P. Okay, how can you show this? So this let us try to take it over here and solve it by ourselves. So how can you solve this particular formula? So let me put the formulas here and let us try to solve. Okay. So please help me in solving, because I need your help. So help me how we can solve. So you know that P, what is given to me, let me choose a brush. I have P R Q. This is the, since this is premise, means it is given, okay. It is given to me. This is the first line. And then what I can say that if I use the P and come up with some way, if I come up to the X, and what is X? I need to find out Q R P. Every time I'm doing those things, that is always not means reverse engineering. Every time I'm doing, most of the time it is not advisable, but just for you, increase your understanding, I'm going to do these things, okay. I'm doing those things, okay. All right. And similarly, the second thing could be that you start from the Q, because P for this thing here, this thing here, from the second thing you start from the Q, and again you reach to the same thing, QRP. If this happens, then you can say that QRP. Can you see this? Can you see this framework? Do you understand this framework? Can anybody write yes for this? Yes? All right. I'm very happy that you understand this framework. So this is the framework, na? This is the framework we have already talked about. This is the framework, okay? Means if something R, Q, something is given, then from the phi and psi, from both you start and you give me this thing, okay? So how can you give this thing? How can from given P you say P R Q? How can you say this? From given Q Q R P, how can you say this? Can anybody tell me? Can you? Correct. All right. Somebody has given me exactly the same thing, that this you can utilize the first formula, because given the P. No, second formula, because this thing is over here, na? The I2, you can use I2, okay? You can use I2, introduction of R I2, And you say that definitely given P I can write like this, given Q I can write like this. Okay, here at the here I1, here R introduction I1. So this is the both the formulas are actually going to be used. So you know that it was a very simple and funny problem. It was nothing important. Looks like very difficult. So you start from this premise and you say that P, and with the P you can use the introduction I2 rule, and similarly from the Q you can write this particular thing, and then you can conclude this particular part. Alright. So now I have another question. Can you solve this? Q implies R. Okay. Gives you P R Q P R R. So can you solve this thing? So let me take the printer screen. Let me put it here. So I would like to, I would love so that you can solve by yourself. Okay, if you can, solve it by yourself, then I would. I think why it is not coming. Let me take the printer screen once again. Put it here. Okay, so let me crop these things. I need this formula to show you. This you have to show. You have to show this thing. Okay. So let me take it here. Control X, Control A, delete, Control V, and now let me increase it. Huh? Can you prove this? Can you help me to proving this? Okay. How difficult it is? Is it very difficult? Okay. So what is given to you? What is given to you? Just see this. This is given to you. This is given to you. What is given to you? Q R. Alright. Then you have to prove this particular part. How can you prove this? I told you that if you put P R Q and inside, and somehow you reduce to P R R, then you are done. Okay. And inside the first statement you can by yourself assume, because this is your area. You are creating by yourself. So you can say that I am creating an area where P R Q. Please note down, many other time I am telling you in the examination it's a similar point of question, similar kind of questions are asked, and you are not putting the these rectangles, you'd be getting zero. Okay. This rectangle is very, very, very important, and closing is also important. So this is premise. Okay, because this is given, this is the thing it was given. Then you need this part. You have taken it. You have to reach till something, that is P R, and I don't know how you can reach it. If you can reach it till this point, then you can write P R Q implies P R R. Okay, this is our target. How can we fill inside the things? So this is the part how we can fill. Okay, again the same formulation I am going to use, because something is given to you. So you can say that I have two boxes, and in the both the boxes, in one box you can start by P, taking P, in the second box you can start by taking Q, and at the end if you reach P R R P R R, then you can say that I can take this out because of this. All right. Now I have not done any logic. I have only applied formula till now. Now point is, how can I get this particular formulation? How can from P I can get the P R R? So you know that this is not possible. This is not difficult to see. That is very easy. Somebody told me that how can I get this formula? Na? From you say that. This you say that this is P and this is P and this is phi is R. So you can use R of I1. Okay, R I1. By this you can immediately do it. So this is done. Somebody, the first box is here. Okay. All right. So in the second box, how should I go ahead? How can I get the PRR? Because at both the places, the same thing is needed, na? You know, here same thing is needed. So then only you can take the X. So therefore, if you want this, so you need this and this. Okay. How can I get PNRR? Again, the problem. But here you can see one thing, that if Q is given to you and Q implies R is there. So can you see this formula? What you get? Q and Q implies R gives you R. Okay. So by this you get R. By this you get R. And when you have R, then you can apply again the same thing, this particular formulation. R is here, R is here, and you could put P or R. So here you can utilize the formulation, what is R of I 2. All right, all the blocks are filled, and therefore you see that this is how we can go ahead and we can create this particular thing. All right, so this particular formulation also you have solved. So I want to give you some more formulas, and I'm going to write them because they are not difficult. This, I think, in the interest of time, we have not solved them, and I would just give you these formulas, and I ask you that please try by yourself. And this is the formula. Okay, please note down this. P and Q or R, okay. P and Q or P and R. Can you show this? Please, everybody, note down this. Okay, I'm going to remove this. I'm not going to solve this. This is not very difficult. Just an exercise for you. Try to come up with this, and that is not going to be. Should be. That should not be difficult, because I can give you the hint only. I say that because these are the AND things, na? So you take two things, okay? You start by this. This is given. You say P and you do something. A Q or R, you do something. Okay? By this you have to come up with this. Okay? This is what the hint is, and you know that Q and R is given, then two boxes you can take. So in box there is Q and another box there is R, and you do something to find out your right solution. Okay, this was the help hint, and you can go ahead. So I think you can solve it now. Should I solve this particular thing? Say no. Can anybody say no? Whatever problem I had given, you can note down. We can try now. Okay, all right. So have you noted down? Say yes. Have you noted down this question? Please note down. Acha, let me tell you one more thing. In between, I think it is better to tell you that you know that there is a website called ktiwari.in. You know this website? Everybody knows this website? Say yes. Say yes. You know this website? I have opened this, but now you know this, okay? All right. Now, you here in the courses, you see the artificial intelligence, okay? AI. It was earlier not there. So now if you go over here, you can see all the slides are there up to lecture 10. So lecture 11 would be available. I think today itself, I would make the slides available, because what happens whenever we upload the things, after some time you get, and there is some gap. So to remove that gap, this, you can get the slides immediately from this particular website, number one. Number two thing, sometime when we are discussing into the lecture, we find out that there is some problem into the slides. Okay, we discuss, we see that this is the typing mistake or whatever the things. Then what I would do, I would go to the home, I would modify the things and put the updated slide over here. All right, so these slides are maybe different than whatever the slide you have taken, that whatever slides are available on your e-learn website. So you better that you take these things from here. All right, you understand those two things? Means immediately you can get the slides from here, and also that they are updated. than the your lecture things. So all right, immediately you can take. Okay, all right. So this is what we are doing. Okay, all right. Next, so we have seen the rule for disjunction, and then again there is a rule that is called the negation rule, and that is also important rule that this is something bad happens, means some contradiction arises. This is a contradiction. So if something contradiction arises, means in your equation itself there is something, so you are telling two things, you are giving two information that are actually not related. Means P and minus P both are somehow I can derive, then I say that it's a contradiction, and when I have a contradiction then I can derive anything, phi, any phi I can derive onwards, because everything has been wrong. It looks very strange, but this is a very important derivation step. Please note down this, and the same thing that is told over here, because if you have some statement and the same you see that there is not of that statement also is given to you, and both the system tells that both the statements are true. What does it mean? That there is a problem, and you say that there is a contradiction, and beyond the contradiction you can assume anything. So this is a very important step. So let us show that the not of P RQ is equal to P implies Q. Okay, so this the proof is like this. Not of P R Q, this is given. Therefore, you can take, because this is given to you. Then you can take two boxes. In one box there is minus P, another box there is minus Q, and both the things come from the premise because this R is given to you. Then minus P is there, and in the you start another box where you say that P, because you can take the P. No, you can take any assumption. And here, since P and minus P both are available, therefore inside what is there? Inside there is a contradiction. Oh my God! Inside there is a contradiction. Outside there is no contradiction, because minus P is there. When this particular inside rectangle closes, then there is no contradiction. But inside there is a contradiction. And when there is a contradiction inside, then you can say that Q. Anything you can assume. So similarly, I have assumed Q. When you assume this thing, then you can write P implies Q. Okay, you can write P implies Q. So outside, because you started from something, you reach to something, then you can write anything. So see, this is a kind of statement that you have generated. And similarly, from the Q, you say that if the Q is there, then you assume P, and then you get P. How can I get Q? Q was there, you got P, then you again write P. How can you write again P? Because P is available, Q is available to you, Q was there, you assumed P, and inside what is available? P is also available and Q is also available. Therefore, you can write Q. And when the same thing, that when the in a bracket you start from the Q, reach to the Q, you write P implies Q. So both the lines, minus P you started, you reach to the P implies Q. Q you started, you reach P implies Q. So you can assume that P implies Q, because from the both the places you reach over there, you can apply the same formulation and reach over here. So here we have used the contradiction at one place, and therefore you can see that the how we can find out this kind of proofs. And this is a very interesting formula. You see, this is a very interesting formula. Most of the time, if I give you the P implies Q, and I say that remove this implication. Sometimes I can ask that I give you P implies Q, and I ask that remove this implication. So instead of this thing, you can write minus P R Q directly. You can write this thing. This formula you can by yourself write. Okay, all right. Next, I have a question. P implies Q, and P implies minus Q. Then this implies minus P. Can you prove this? Okay. Next question is this. Okay. So all right. How can I prove this? Let me just write this so that it becomes easy for you. So this is what the formulation is. I want this thing to be shown. Control X, Control A, delete Control V. Okay, I write. I want to prove this. Okay. So what is given? I think this is not very difficult to see. Given is P implies Q. What is it? And what else is given? P implies minus of Q. Okay, both the things are given. So in the inner side, you assume P. Okay. You assume P right. If you assume P, what you get by this Q? Let me write the question number 1, 2, 3, 4. By 1 and 3, you get Q. Similarly, you can find out, you can apply P over here also, and you can get minus Q. Means by 2 and 3, you get minus of Q. Both the things you got. This is the line number 5. So therefore, you say that I got a contradiction. So whenever you get a contradiction, you can assume anything. Okay, whenever you get a contradiction, you can assume anything, and then you say minus of P. Acha, nahi, nahi. There is one more thing. Because you can only assume the things inside. How can you assume anything outside? Okay. So for that, there is one more formula, and this is missing into this particular thing. That what is this formula? That in your things, if you start by phi, and you do something, and you at the end you reach to the contradiction. What does it mean? It means that your assumption was wrong. Therefore, you can say minus of phi. Are you with me? This is a very simple thing. Means you started, but you have some assumption, say phi. You did something, and you find out that there is a contradiction. What does it mean? It immediately means that your assumption was false. So this was your assumption, that P was your assumption. You did something and you reached to the contradiction. Therefore, this was minus of P, because this assumption was wrong. All right? Okay, one more problem. One more problem. Let me solve like this. And the problem is this. I think this we have done. Okay, this was the problem. Okay, we have done. All right. So this was with me. This particular problem we have solved. So, okay. So this thing is not difficult. Now, after solving this particular thing, we are going to see the logical equivalences. You know, alpha and beta is equal to beta and alpha. This is the commutativity law. And next you see that alpha r is also commutative. Okay, so do you understand this, that r is commutative? Okay, yes. Similarly, if I say that a and b and alpha and beta and gamma, so you can say that sometime that alpha and beta and gamma, this is called the associativity rule. Okay, and the next rule is the associativity also goes with the disjunction. So you say that alpha r beta r gamma is equal to alpha r beta r gamma. That is straightforward. I think you have seen this. Double negation actually vanishes, and therefore double negation of alpha is equal to alpha. So alpha implies beta, means minus beta implies minus alpha. This is contrapositive. This is an important thing. Please try to see this. Alpha implies beta. Contrapositive is minus beta implies minus alpha. Alpha implies beta. You see that very recently we have seen the proof that alpha implies beta is minus of alpha or beta. All right. And if it is a two-sided arrow, it means that alpha implies beta and beta implies alpha. This is the biconditional elimination. It is just a new formula. So you know this. Minus of alpha and beta. So you see that there is a De Morgan's law that tells that it is minus of alpha or minus of beta. The most look, we can ask into the exam that what is the proof for this. So you can try to see that, come up with the proof like earlier we have done. See this thing. Minus of alpha r beta, r becomes and, minus of alpha minus of beta. Okay, this is also called the De Morgan's rule, and this is a very important thing, and this is called that alpha and beta r gamma. So this AND actually would be distributed inside. So alpha and beta, alpha and gamma, and outside there is R. Okay. So this is a strain kind of formula. And similarly, if we reverse those things, R can also be distributed on AND. So see, alpha R beta, it goes inside. So alpha R beta and alpha R gamma. All right. So all these things are important. And let me highlight two, three things that are very important, and you should take care of them. Okay. First, this formula is important. This formula is very important. Number one. Second, this formula is important. This formula is a specific formula that is difficult to see. Third, this formula is important. All other things are kind of not that difficult to see, but these three formulas you should take care. In case you have any problem, please let me know. Okay. Then very important property we are going to talk about, that if a logical system is given to you, so sometime we can ask that whether this system is sound or whether this system is complete. Soundless, soundness and completeness, these things are going to be asked from you, that whether this is sound or this system is sound or this system is complete and what it is. Okay. So let me just give you what is soundness and completeness. So just giving the definition, in the terms of definition, we can say soundness means doing right thing. Okay, if I'm doing right thing, then I'm sound. And when I'm complete, that if I have full coverage, then I would be complete. Okay, so there is one thing called full coverage. Another thing is doing right thing. Okay, I'm doing right thing. So let me tell you using an example. There are 10 defective bulbs in a box of 25. Okay, I have a box. How many bulbs I have? 10. I have 25 bulbs. Okay. And 10 of them are defective. Okay. So there are 2 persons who are giving me some bulb. Mr. A give me 10 bulbs. None of them is defective. Okay. And Mr. B gives me 20 bulbs. And 5 of them is defective. So I think this problem is not very difficult to understand. Control X, Control A, Delete, Control V. Okay. All right. So I'm telling that there are how many in box there are, how many things are there? 25. Okay. So 10 are defective. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are defective. And these others are good. How many are good? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the good bulbs. Okay. So do you understand this part or not? Okay. Can you understand this? So I have deployed 2 people, Mr. A and Mr. B. Okay. Mr. A gave me 10 bulbs. None of them were defective. Means Mr. A has given me how many bulbs? 10 bulbs. So which bulb is Mr. A has given me? These bulbs. So can you understand this? Now my question is, what is the correctness of Mr. A? How correct Mr. A is? Can you tell me how much correct he is? He is 100% correct. He is 100%. Are you with me? He is 100% correct. Are you with me? Mr. A is 100% correct. Do you understand this? However, his coverage is not complete. His coverage is less because he has left something. Mr. B gives you 20 bulbs. I think I have done a mistake now. 10 were defective. So why you have not told me that? I told you that there are only 25, but you have not told me that this is a problem. Okay, this is only the scenario. Okay, so we have 25. Okay, the question is, we have 25. Okay, this is what we have, 25. All right, this is the scenario. Mr. A has given me these number of bulbs. So what is the happening with the Mr. B? Mr. B has given me 20 bills. How can he give me 20 bills? He can give me 20 bills only in this way. He can give me, Mr. B can give me into this way. Okay, Mr. B can give me into this way. Alright. But now he is not 100% accurate because he has given 5 bulbs wrong. What is his accuracy? What is his accuracy? Can anybody tell? Is it 75%? Mr. B is 75% correct. Is it right? 15 by 20. Because 20 bulbs he has given to me. Is it right? Alright. So, but very interestingly, Mr. B covers all. Okay. And Mr. A never errs. Never does error. Okay. So then we say Mr. A is sound and Mr. B is complete. So when you are going to be complete, it is allowed that okay, thoda sa tum jyada bhi de diya, galat de diya, that is fine. But you should cover all these things. Complete means you should cover all. Soundness means, what is the meaning of soundness? That whatever you are doing right. You may be doing less things, but you are right. Alright, you understand this fact? Okay. So Mr. gives me this, Mr. A B this, therefore A is sound, B is complete. What we want? We want soundness or we want completeness? We want both. Alright? Okay, we want both. Alright. So let us we have a spam filter. Okay. One spam filter is perfect. Okay. Another spam, I have three filters. Three say filter perfect. One is perfect, another is aggressive. And another is conservative. What do you mean by perfect? What do you mean by conservative? Perfect means whenever something is given to you, perfect means whenever an email is given to him, he tells whether it is spam or not. Aggressive means every time all the things it gives, whenever he have some intuition, it tells that it is a spam and it covers all the spams. Okay, it is aggressive. What is conservative? Conservative means it sees that sometime it sees that okay, if I'm not 100% sure, I would not say that it is a spam filter. Conservative, I'm not for 100% sure, then I would not say that it is a spam. Aggressive, whenever I have a small intuition, I would say that it is a spam. Perfect, I would only say that when it is right, then I would say that it is spam, otherwise not. Okay, so can you tell me, my question is, which system is sound? Which system is sound? Which system is sound? A, B, C. Can anybody give me? A is sound. Let me just write. Sound and two things we know. Na? Sound or complete. Alright. Sound means. Right, does right thing. Complete means covers. Okay, so which is sound? Somebody is telling B covers. B is complete. Okay, just tell me who is sound. Who is sound? Sound means it is always right. So conservative is always right. Okay, it is sound. It is sound. Means it is conservative, therefore it is sound. It is perfect, therefore it is also sound. Okay. Whenever it tells conservative, therefore whenever it tells the right thing, therefore it is sound. perfect also does the right thing. If it is aggressive, whenever he have a problem, it may be possible for in the conservative, some of the spam it rejects that it is not spam. So for the completeness, if I want to find out which one is complete, then which one is complete, which one is complete, this aggressive, because every time it is finding, therefore this is complete. And this is also complete. Right? Okay. There is a legal system. Do you understand legal system? Legal system. A and B. A says guilty. What I'm telling you, I'm just right. A says guilty. Guilty until proven innocent. Okay. Second is innocent until proven okay. Somebody is writing that, sir, A will not cover everything right. No, no, it is perfect. Nah, as I myself told you that it is perfect, therefore it would cover everything. Okay. System A is perfect, therefore it would cover everything. Alright. Okay. So can you here tell me that which is sound and which is complete? Sound and complete. Which system is sound, which sentence? Which system is sound, which system is complete? Huh? Sound means doing right. Okay. So you are only going to punish the peoples. You are only going to punish the people who are actually guilty. So which is sound? Somebody is telling B. Everybody agrees with that? B is sound, because you are not given any sentence until it is proven that you have guilty. Okay, please understand, in some of the cases when somebody is guilty, it may not be proven. In that case, he would be freed. Okay, but the people who get the sentence, they are proven guilty, so therefore they definitely have done some problem. So therefore, this is innocent until proven guilty is sound. Is it complete? Whether the system B is complete? No, because there would be some peoples for whom you would not be able to prove that he is guilty. Because his mother had told that don't eat sweets, but mother was not there. He have eaten the sweet. He has done the he had done some problem, okay, a bad thing, but he cannot be proven because nobody is there to witness him, so he is innocent. Okay, so he cannot be proven guilty. So therefore, B system is sound only, it is not complete. Now let us talk about A. Guilty until proven. Mother comes, he tells that there is less sweets, he says that you have the problem, you have done this. It may be possible somebody else has taken the sweet, but here you would be punished. In the system A is complete, every time whether system A is complete, if system is complete, system A is complete. Correct? Are you with me? All right, system A is complete, system B is sound. Okay, this is a very important thing. Now, next thing that we want to discuss over here is the conjunctive normal form. Means if we can write everything in the conjunction of disjunctions, then it is called the conjunctive normal form or CNF. Sometimes we want to say the implication free, means for example if this is a formula, so we can make it implication free. And negative normal form, sometimes we also make them into the negative normal form. Negative normal form says that don't put the double negation because they look ugly. Okay. So next thing that we want to discuss is this, that we have a statement and we want to find the conjunctive normal form of any statement that is A. Alright, of any statement that is A, and what is the A? This is the statement. Okay, so let me put it here. So we want to find out the this particular thing. Okay, alright, we want to find out this. So this is what we want to find out. Okay. Oh my god. So we have to apply three things: conjunctive normal form, negative normal form, and implication free. First we have to make it implication free. So let me tell you that these things are pretty easy, and you know that these things are very, you know, if I say that A implies B, so I told you that negation of A or B, you can write like this. Okay, you can write like this. So if I say that I want to find out the implication free something, I want to find out the implication free of this particular statement, say control C, control V. So let me solve this part first. Okay. Implication free. So if I want to make this implication free, so what would happen? So implication, where is the implication? Here is the implication only. So here is the implication. So I say that this is the first part and this is the second part. So I put the implication free, so I can utilize this formula. I say that minus of minus P and Q or P and R implies Q. Is it right? Say yes, no? It's very simple, the same thing. We have applied over there. This formula, can we apply like this? Yes? Okay, very good. But again there is a problem, because here we have implication. So here also we can remove the implication by putting minus of R or Q, okay, and P or, and if you wish, we can take this thing inside. So I can say minus of P or minus of Q. This thing, this is the formulation. So implication form is this. Alright, you got it? Very simple. That this is what the, now there is no implication. So we, it is implication free. If I ask you that make it implication free, you can do it like this. Very simple. Now next thing is the negative normal form. Negative normal form says that, so we have solved this particular part. We have solved what we have solved. We have solved this thing. Control Z, let me say. Let me take it. Control C, Control V. So let me, I think yeah, the irony. So okay, not C. So let me just apply the second thing, NNF. Okay. So negative normal form says that the double negation looks ugly. NNF says that double negation looks ugly. So whenever there is double negation, you put single negation. That's it. So NNN, you just see this formula, and whenever there is a double negation, you see, because it's a double negation, you see P R minus Q, okay, or P and minus R or Q. This is again the NNF. This is the NNF. NNF, because we don't have any double negations over here. This is implication IMPL free. It is implication free. Okay, so we have done both the things, and now we want to find out the conjunctive normal form. And conjunctive normal form is something into this way. Conjunctive normal form. So you see this, just see this particular thing. it is, everything is conjunction of disjunction. Okay, you want this conjunction of disjunctions. Conjunction means something. Conjunction, you want conjunctions. Okay, you want conjunctions. Means there is phi, then conjunction, psi, conjunction, and something different thing. Alpha, beta. This is conjunctive normal form. Conjunction. Where this thing alone can be, you say that A or B kind of thing. This thing could be A, B, R minus P, R minus Q. So you can put this thing is this thing. So this kind of expression you should need to find out. Okay. So here you see that how can you find out this thing into the conjunctive normal form? See very carefully. It's very easy. It's not very difficult. You see that you say that this is going to be one part. Okay. And this is R, and you can distribute it inside. You know this formula that A, R, B, and C. What happens? And this is a C part. Okay. So this is formula you are going to apply. So this you are going to say that as an A. This you are treating as a. This you are treating as a B, and this you are treating as a C. So in this formula, what we have seen earlier, you see that there was a formula, no? Here was a formula. Here we have seen. Okay, this last formula, alpha r beta and alpha r gamma. This formula we are going to use. Okay, all right. So how we are going to use this? It says that you utilize A. You can write it A. You write it A, R, B, and A, R, C. This is how you should write. All right. So can you help me to writing over there? So we should write A or B. So this means P, R, minus Q, R, P. Okay. This is the first part. And you say A. A or C, so you write A, P R minus Q, okay, A, and then you need C. C is this part. What is this? R. With the R, you can write all these things. Negative of R, Q. That's it. Okay, so this is what it is, conjunctive normal form. However, you can further simplify this by saying that PRQ is P. Okay, you can see that PRQ, you know, na PR. Let me just remove this part because I have very less space. So let me say that PRP is equal to P. Similarly, QR minus Q is 1. QR minus PR minus P is equal to 1. How come? When, because R becomes 1, if it is 0, then it becomes 0. It is 0, then it becomes 1. At least there, somewhere there is 1. And A and P R 1 is equal to 1. P R 1 is equal to 1. So you can find out very good simplification over here, but at least I can say that you should do this much, that that you say that this P is not needed, because this can be merged into here. So you say P R minus Q, and here I think the biggest big problem is here, because you say that when you R this with this minus of Q, because you can change the order also. So that is also a good thing, but when you merge these two things, they become 1, and in the R, if there is 1, it becomes completely 1. So either you can say that PR minus R or 1 and one actually with the one what you see that everything get collapses. Okay, this part collapses, this part goes away. Okay, this part goes away, this part goes away. So in the simplification, this part goes away because one is taken R, therefore it goes away. Only this part remains. Okay, all right. So we have seen one way that in this, how can you do a, how can you find out the implication free conjective negative normal form and conjective normal form. This is what we have seen, and we have seen that how we can solve it. Then next topic is a Horn clause, and Horn clause is not a difficult thing. That here you know, no, we have earlier seen that how we can the first session we have seen that how we can create some expressions. So this is the grammar by which the things are generated, and actually starting symbol is H. If you use H and you can generate some formula using this grammar rules, then whatever you generate is called the Horn clause. What does it mean? Horn clause says that there could be C, and C is A implies B, and A could be P and A and B kind of thing, and C could be C and H. Okay, and H at the end would be that you some when you say it is A to P, then the P could be true, it is not, it is false. Okay, contradiction means false. This T is true, and this is P, some statement. P Q R something in dot dot dot. I think there should be some P dot dot dot. It's various formulas you can take. So you can say that these things should be you can take. So what are the formulas that you can make using this? Okay, the question is, what are the formulas that you can make out of this? All right. Okay. So let me write some formulas. Please tell me that can you form them or not? Okay, this is a very simple exercise. And can you say me that we can form P R minus Q? I say P Q, everything is possible. P R P no. Let me write like this. Let me take this formula. P and Q and S implies P. Okay, Q S. Everything is there, and P and R implies P, and P and S implies S. Is it possible to create? And here this AND is saying that if I can create individually, I would be creating individually these item. Can I create this item? Yes. Can I create this item? Yes. Can I create this item? Yes. All these things I can create using this formulation or this grammar. So therefore, this is a Horn formula. This is a Horn formula. All right. See the next example. Okay. I say P and Q and S implies not of P, and Q and R implies P. And P and S implies S. Okay, can it be made? Can you find out? Can you make it? This we can make. Yes. This also we can make. Can you make this? There is a negation, and there is no way to get the negation from here. Can you get the negation? So therefore, this cannot be made. So therefore, if even if a single part cannot be made, it is not a Horn formula. So similarly, you can see that there could be various examples. And I just give you the homework that try to see that is it possible? P and Q and S implies false, and Q and R implies P, and true implies yes. Is it possible? This is one formula for you, homework. Second formula is this, P and Q and yes implies P and yes, and true implies P, and Q and yes implies, can we make it like this? So these two things are for your homework. I'm not going to solve them. You by yourself try to see that what is the answer for them. All right? Okay. Now what is important is this, that whenever you have this kind of formula, so there is a way to find out that whether it is satisfiable or not, whether it is satisfiable or not. And for that, this is the rule. And I'm going to tell you these rules. I'm going to tell you these rules on one of the formula, and then you have to by yourself figure out and what should be done. Okay, so this is actually a kind of control X, control A, delete, control V. So let me just try to find out, there are some formula are given and I want to find out whether this formula is true or not, is satisfiable or not. Okay, satisfiable means can you find out an assignment that can make it true. All right. So this is the algorithm to find out a satisfiability, and the formula says that mark tree if there is there. So you see that at how many places there is true, true is here, true is here, true is here. So you mark the true these things. Okay, these things are marked. Okay, so you mark that. Okay, done is done it. It is also done it. Then you use second formula. Then go for the second formula. Second formula says that if something implies something is there. And if this side, all these things are marked, then you say that this item is also marked. Alright. Means since for this formula, this everything into the left hand side has been marked, so therefore R is also marked. Okay, so you got R as a marked. Similarly here you got Q as a marked. Okay. Similarly here you got yes as a marked. Okay. So marked means they becomes true. So whenever in this formula you see that somewhere there is R, you see that it is marked. This is also marked. Okay, R, is there anywhere R? No. Similarly, when you mark this, you see Q is anywhere there, Q, it is also marked. Okay. Okay, this is done. Is there anywhere yes? It is also marked. No, there is yes. Alright. So when you mark this, then what is left? P and W is left. P, W, so since these formula, so you see that the truth assignment can be done, the truth assignment is done for them. This is, I think true, whereas P was also there. This we forget, so P is also marked. When P is marked, you cut from here. So what is left? So the true assignment is there, true assignment you got, I think U is not there. So this, I think, how have we marked like this? I think we have done a mistake now. U was marked, U was not marked. So this is also not marked. I think control Z. Let me once again do it, okay? So that there is no problem. Okay, let me tell you how I'm going to do it. So the way is this, that you see that true, 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 you mark it. Then you true implies R, so you R kill R all everywhere, R is killed. And then you see true implies P, so you kill P everywhere. Is there anywhere P? No P. Then you see that 2 implies Q, so you kill Q everywhere. Then you, whatever, what is left? You say that it is left, that W implies tautology, not, and okay. It's not tautology, it's a contradiction, and then you see T implies contradiction. Okay, only these two things, I think this is also there. U implies yes. My question is, can you find out an assignment that makes this statement true? Okay, you make T is equal to 0. Can you find out this assignment? W is equal to 0. Can you find out this assignment? Okay, since U and S are independent, and there were no much conditions over there, you say that yes, I can assign this one and this also one. So therefore, this assignment is satisfiable. You got this? Simple thing. This assignment is, this formula is satisfiable. Okay. So this is the satisfiability of this particular statement. Let me give you a second. Let me find out one more example, and then we are done. Let me take this example also. Second example. So one more example. Let me get the pen. Okay. Truth is equal to U. So you kill U everywhere. Where is the U? Is there any U? There is no U. True is equal to R. So you kill R everywhere. Is there anywhere R? R is here. You kill this R. And where R is here, kill R over here. And you see that something implies P, and it was true. So you kill P everywhere. P, you kill P from here. From here you can kill P nowhere. True is equal to Q. So true is equal to Q. So you can find out Q. You can kill Q over here. Anywhere you can kill the Q? No. Okay. So what is left? I think is it the same thing that we have solved? No. So you see what is left? U left is this. W naught and T was there. T tails to naught. What is left? U, W. Somebody is telling U is also true. I just missed this particular line. U, W, U, yes. So can you find out an assignment? If this is false, so you make W and T false. If W is false, then you can make yes. Yes, this also false. Means you put 0 over here. You put 0 and 0 assigned to these things, then 0 implies false, 0 implies false. So it is true. All those becomes true. Zeros, you put 0 over here, so 0 becomes true. W, and since W is independent, and I think W you put 0, then become true. You become this, so you find out an assignment. Yes, that is true. So this is how you find out that how to get that whether there is an assignment that is satisfiable or not. Okay. So all right, that's all. I think let me just see that whether we have anything else today. So that's all for today. So I just tell you that you read these chapters even from Rasan and Norang, and there is another book, Hut and Rayan, and chapter 1 we have covered from there. You see these things from here. Okay. That is straightforward. So in case you have any question, you can ask. Okay. I'm closing the